we have a certain conception of reality that's largely derived from the progress of the sciences over the past three centuries. And we think that ultimately reality must be material. And then we find, my gosh, we're all conscious. We all have this inner qualitative, subjective stuff, and that seems mysterious.
It's the aspect of consciousness that plays a role in one's cognitive life, thinking, noticing, etc. What he leaves out is what I call phenomenal consciousness, what it's like to experience red as opposed to experience green.
How do human beings constitute themselves as subjects? Indeed, the constitution of subjectivity undoubtedly provides the perspective from which the more familiar Foucauldian concerns with power and with the history of sexuality can best be understood. For if the fundamental exercise of power over individuals is their own confessional interpretation of themselves, then a study of networks of power inevitably leads to a dismantling analysis of the technologies of the self.
But the old boundaries between what was my information
and what was yours have become confused.
Do you have low self-esteem? Do you like yourself? So here's what it should look like. It can be a difficult existence to choose.
Every particle of this universe contains the whole of the universe. You and yourself have the whole of the universe. I cut you up in a certain way, and I cut up the universe.
China was able to turn the corner and become the leading world superpower because they have a police state and they are able to force people to stop reproducing.
me, you know.
E stands for everyone.
So people, in a sense, are being hollowed out. It isn't only television that is doing it. Television, as it were, is filling an increasingly empty vessel. That's what's happening. And they're taking over the world of imagination, taking over that world, that dream world, that magnificent dream world that the child still has, and which the rest of civilization repeatedly represses in the course of what we call maturation or becoming mature. Television has begun to fill that in with its synthetic plots, with its advertising, with this one-dimensional pictorial image of what reality is all about.
I have succeeded in becoming my own worst enemy.